behalf of the bishops of the Church of Uganda and all the Christians and our visiting bishops and archbishops, I want to take this opportunity to welcome.
You're welcome to the meeting.
Can I stand here on behalf of the confessing Anglicans of the three Americas? And this is both the North America, the Central America, and the South America. 13 countries where these Anglican Christians are faithful to the teaching of the apostles according to the scriptures.
I also bring greetings from the Archbishop of Sydney, the Most Reverend Dr. Glenn Davies. And I have a message from Dr. Glenn that he would like me to read to you. To my dear brother in Christ, Archbishop Stephen, please accept my warm greetings from the Diocese of Sydney. I also send greetings from all Orthodox Anglicans from Asia and Oceania in my capacity as the Gafcon Deputy General Secretary for this region. The Church of Uganda has been a source of encouragement for faithful Anglicans around the world as you place the biblical witness to Jesus at the centre of your church life. We have walked with the Church of Uganda and we continue to value this vibrant church as a key gospel partner. Archbishop Stephen, we are so thankful to God for your appointment and wish you and your family God's richest blessing in the coming days. Faithful Anglicans seek an Anglican church around the world which is committed to Jesus and which submits itself to the authority of the scriptures.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
As the Archbishop of North America, I want to say thank you for coming to our rescue. North America. You took us in when we were spiritual and church orphans. You nurtured and shepherded us. You consecrated bishops for us. You were the one of the original provinces to call for a new province in North America. You helped birth the Anglican Church in North America. I would like to say to the Church of Uganda that you have been a bright light in the Anglican community and for our fellow Christians around the world. You have stood tall for the truth of the gospel. You have been unwilling to ignore the clear, plain teaching of scripture and the morality taught thereof. While many have tried to get you to compromise and to violate your biblical conscience, even many leaders in our Anglican community, you have said no. You will not disobey the word of God. Millions of the faithful men and women of God all over the world who faithfully attend their churches each Sunday and work in their local communities, they look to you and your faithfulness and are encouraged and strengthened and motivated to follow Jesus more courageously in their own context because of your example. Many others look to their own leaders in bewilderness and confusion as these leaders ignore their consciences, ignore the teaching of the Bible, and partake of those who are living in sin. And they wish their leaders would be more like you. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who is the judge of the living and the dead, and by his appearing in his kingdom, preach the word.
I love the words of unknown author who said that God has a tendency of calling a nobody to become somebody in front of everybody without consulting anybody. My calling and personal mission is that I want Christ to be known by word and life in the power of the Holy Spirit. My conviction is that everything that I do and say should make what you know in the power of the Holy Spirit. We shall continue to emphasize marriage as the lifelong exclusive bond between one man and one woman. Lambeth's Resolution 110 captured the Bible's teaching very well when it said, in view of the teaching of Scripture, the bishops must uphold faithfulness in marriage between a man and a woman in lifelong union. And believe that abstinence is right for those who are not called to marriage. It also rejects homosexual practice as incompatible with Scripture, and cannot advise the legitimizing or blessing of the same-sex unions, nor condemning those involved in the same-gender unions. Lambeth Resolution 110 therefore rules out the possibility of the Church over-supporting or blessing same-sex marriage or any parallel institution to marriage for same-sex unions. This is a trend in the Western world, and some Anglican churches in those contexts are being pressurized into doing this, including our Mother Church of England. But for us in Uganda, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. God has called us to be wounded healers, bridge builders, and conduits of blessing, hope, healing, and forgiveness. Let us jointly learn to cooperate, collaborate, coordinate, communicate, accept to be corrected, and get connected to Christ through the cross. Let us aim at conversion of the head, heart, and hand for better ministry in the Church of Uganda and Uganda at large, and to fulfill our vision of a faster, growing, sustainable Christ-centered church. This calls for prayer partners, because without prayer, whatever we do either backfire, misfire, or makes no fire by unknown author. Yours, the most reverend Dr. Stephen Samuel Kaziimba, Archbishop of the Church of America.